Hello students, welcome back. This is Vasant Naik from Canada Engineering College. Welcome to my channel, VashTech. So we'll continue the module 5 portion of microprocessor and microcontroller. That is nothing but ARM instructions. In the last video, you must have seen arithmetic and logical instructions. So all these instructions are the comes under data processing instructions. So today's class, you will see comparison instructions. See, comparison instructions, it will compare two numbers. Only thing is, here you need not to suffix S. For this instruction, you need not to suffix S. Without suffixing S itself, the instruction coming in this category will update the flag register. So, because these instructions are meant for updating the flag register, that's why you need not to update S like in add instruction, we will suffix S for flag register update. Subtract instruction, we will suffix S. Moves, etc. But in comparison instruction, you need not to suffix S. These are the category of comparison instructions which will automatically update flag register without suffixing S to the instruction. So compare CMP, compare, what it will do, it will actually compare instruction will subtract source from destination, and based on the condition like the whether the destination is greater or equal or smaller, flags are affected. So it will set the flag as a result of Rn minus n. Compare negated, see, when I use compare instruction in this format, this is destination, this is source, right? Yeah. So what I will do is, when you use the compare instruction like this, it is something like Rn minus n. Agree? This is destination, this is source. Compare negated means, negated value of the source is compared. Already this is minus n, and negated, that the limit becomes plus n. So you can see here, compare negated is this one. Then test for equality of the two numbers. Then test bits of 32-bit value, TST, TEQ. These are the other versions of other instruction related to comparison. You can see here, R0 is 4, R9 is equal to 4. When you compare instruction, initially you can see here in the instruction, CPSR is, CPSR status, carry flag is, zero flag is not set. But after instruction, after comparing, zero flag is set. This indicates both are 0, 0. While comparing, zero flag is set. That indicates this is equal, both numbers are equal. When both numbers are equal, zero flag is set. So, similarly, we have two more instruction. Test instruction is the logical AND operation. And TQU, test equal, exclusive OR operation. So you have to remember this one. Multiply instruction. Multiply instructions, we have two versions, MUL and MLA. MUL multiply. So for MLA is multiply with accumulate. So now here you can see multiply. Instruction syntax, multiply with accumulate is something like this. So now multiply, we know, so multiply instruction, you can write for example MUL, I can write this is R0 and R1 and R2. R1 and R2 can multiply and store the result in R0. So here That's why they have used different symbol for the operand. So R0, R1 and R2. Here you see which is R2, which is R1 and which is R0. Multiply with the accumulate. What do you mean by multiply with the accumulate? For example, I want to multiply 1, 2, 1 with the 1, 2, 1. What I will do? Normal multiplication, paper multiplication, like 1 into 1, 1, 2, 1, 1. Then next one is 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, and 2 ones are 2. Then is 1 to 1. Then finally, I will add. So in paper work, we will add like this: 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 4, 4, 5, 6, 2, 2, 4, and something like this. But how the computer will do the multiplication? Computer will take register, and as it multiplies the first this one iteration, it will store that one. When it multiplies the second iteration, it will add that to that register. Then third time, it will add that to register. So computer will work like this. That is called as multiply and accumulate. While during the multiplication, it will accumulate whatever answer it gets during the multiplication iteration. So this is called as multiply with accumulate. In multiply, we have long multiply. 64-bit multiplication also is there. You will see that all those things. You can see here. Signed multiply, accumulate long, in that different variations, signed multiply long, unsigned multiply, accumulate long, unsigned multiply. When you multiply 32-bit into 32-bit register, the result is the results in 64-bit. For that, we are using separate registers to store separate register to store the 64-bit. So you can see here, one register for storing higher bits, MSB, one register is storing lower bits. So separate register we are using. So similarly, unsigned multiply accumulate. We know unsigned multiply accumulate, this is the syntax. It will take the register with the zero, then it will, whatever it will multiply, that will accumulate to this register. So final register value is this one. Signed multiply with long. Signed multiply with the long. This is similar to this one, and unsigned signed multiply with the accumulate. So you can see here, this is the value. When you multiply R1 and R2, it will be stored in R0. Long multiply produce 64-bit result. That's why we are using 32-bit two register. We are labeled as two register RDL0 and RDHI. RDL0 and RDHI. RDL0 holds the lower 32-bit value of 64-bit result. RDHI holds the higher 32-bit value of 64-bit result. So what is the unsigned multiplication? What is the syntax? You can see here syntax, unsigned multiplication. It will multiply R2 and R3, and the result is stored in R0 and R1. Instead of syntax like this, you can write, you can explain with the example. If you can't remember syntax, this one and all, because it is very easy for us to say, like when we explain. But for student, when she or he gives the exam, she or he has to remember entire syllabus, that time it becomes very difficult to remember syntax and all, that time. So you can directly explain. So explain like this. Here it is very easy to remember. R2 and R3 is multiplying. It is unsigned multiplication, long multiplication. Long multiplication results in 64-bit. So results are stored in R0 and R1. Next one is the branch instruction. In the branch instruction, changes the flow of execution. In branch instruction, we have three types of branch instruction: B, BL, BX, and BLX. B means branch to the particular location. That location is given by PC, program counter. Second one is branch with link. So branch with link, branch to the particular location, but link register holds the address of the next instruction to be executed after BL. Branch exchange. So branch exchange. Branch exchange with the link. So we have to see all these things one by one. So in the exam, branch instruction means you have to write this one. Branch condition label, branch condition label, etc. So now we'll see first branch instruction. First one, branch. Here you can see label forward. So as soon as it comes, when the execution comes here, it will come here. It will execute this one. It will execute this one. For example, suppose the execution proceeds in this way. Execution proceeds in this way. When it comes here, it will branch it to backward here. So that is B with the label. So next one is, you can see here, branch L, branch with the link. Means not only branch to the particular location, but it will remember where it has to come back after execution of that branch. For example, here you can see BL subroutine. That means here one instruction is there, BL subroutine. After that, these are instruction. Subroutine is here. Now, when it branch to the subroutine, then we have program counter or link we have program counter and link register. Link register will store the address of this instruction, because after coming back here, after execution of this subroutine, it has to come back and it has to start the execution here, right? That's why that is called as branch with the link register. So here it will come, see here in this case, it will come to subroutine. In this case, it will come to subroutine. It will execute all those things. After that, whatever there in the, it will execute the subroutine code. This is subroutine code is there. Think subroutine code is there. Then it will move the link register value to PC, program counter. Then it will return here and it will continue the execution from here. That is called as branch with the link. Next two instructions are there, branch exchange with link, third type of branch instruction. Branch exchange instruction uses absolute address stored in register RM. It is primarily used to branch to and from thumb code. In that case, T bit in the CPSR is updated by at least a significant bit of the branch register. Similarly, BLX instruction updates T bit of the CPSR with the least significant bit and additionally set the link register with the return address. So that is about branch instruction. In the exam, if 7 to 8 marks question, you have to write all those things. Then next set of instruction is load and store instruction. Next set of instruction is load and store instruction. So in the load and store instruction, we have three types. Single register transfer, multiple register transfer, and swap instruction. Once we finish load and store instruction, then software interrupt instruction, then program status register instruction. So with that, our fifth module will be over. So now we'll see first one is a single register transfer. What is there in single register transfer? So here only one register is used to transfer and load and store. Load instruction, load register, it will So we have load and store instruction. This is the format. Instead of this one, you will directly move to here. Load register. Load word into register from memory. From memory, it will load the register with word. Store register. Store the register into memory. Store the register content into memory. Here load the register. This is equivalent to, if I write here, this is equivalent to pop instruction. This is equivalent to push instruction. See, push instruction means what? Push the content from the register to memory. pop the content from memory to register. Please remember, pop instruction and push instruction. So now, LDRB and STRB, load byte. So I told you people, like in the earlier video, ARM execute 8-bit instruction, 16-bit instruction, and 32-bit instruction. 32-bit is a word in ARM. Please don't confuse. In 8086, I told 16-bit is word. Means at a time it can process 16-bit. That is the word length. In ARM, at a time it can process 32-bit because the register size are 32-bit. Data bus width is 32-bit. Instructions are 32-bit instructions. That's why the word length is 32-bit. Here, 32-bit. Half word means 16-bit. And byte means anyway 8-bit. So, please remember this one. So, here it will load byte into register. It is also same. Then here, load half word into register, save half word into register. Load signed byte into register, load signed half word into register. These many, if you can't remember syntax, at least you should know which is pop instruction, which is push instruction, and you know what is the meaning of this one. So now we'll see here, load register, LDR R0 R1. This is pop instruction. Pop means it will load the content register with the memory. So memory address is given by here. You see, memory address is given by this one. Any register enclosed in bracket indicates address, right? This is address. From this address, content is loaded to R0. Content is loaded to R0. And this one is equivalent to this one. Here we have given displacement also. So you remember in addressing mode of 8086, relative base index, base relative, base index, base relative, there it is nothing but offset. We are using base plus offset, index and relative, and then one more is the index relative, and then displacement, something like that. For time being I can't remember exactly, so I can't recall exactly that one right now. Anyway, so here also you can see this is the offset address. Similarly, you can store is equal to push. So where you have to store this content, this one, see here it is, now this becomes source and this becomes a destination. Please remember, here this becomes a destination, this is source, right? From memory you are loading, here storing from here to here. So format is same, but destination and source changes when you see this. So in a single register load and store addressing mode, we have free index with write back. Three modes are there: forced index, free index, forced index. Free index with write back calculates an address from the base register plus address offset, then update the address base register with new address. Free index with write, free index is the same as the free index with write back, but it doesn't update the address base register. Forced index only update the address base register after the address is used. So you have to remember this one, very important. So here you see, here it will use base and offset, but this is updated, this is not updated. Let us see this with the example, you will better understand. Example is here, R0 R1 is given, and now memory with this location 9000 and 9004. Now you see, this is the given data, R0, we have one register, R1 one register. Now LDR with this one, it has to form the address location R1. What is the R1? 9000. 9000 content is this one, 9004 content is this one. You may ask why it is 4. ARM is 32 bit. That's why it is 4 consecutive location. In 8086, it is 16 bit word length is equal. It is 2 consecutive locations. Here it is 4 consecutive locations. So next instructions is something like next location is 4. So this one. Now what this will do? Free index with the write back. Free index with the write back, what it will do? We will see first one. Free index with the write back. Free index with the write back calculates the address from the base register plus address offset, then update the address base register with new address. So here it will calculate the address from base register. So R1 is this one and offset. So it has got value this one. This value is moved to R0. So now here R0 become this one. After that it will update the base register. Earlier base register was 9000. It will update the base register. This is free index with write back. Free indexing also will do the same thing. But it will not update the base register. See, it will not update the base register. Forced index, what it will do is, it will use the address first, R1. What is there in the R1? This one. And it will move that content to R0. Yeah. After that it will update the address 9004. You try to understand here once again. Free index with write back. Here given information is R1 is given. Nodi illi R0 matte R1 kottidare. R0 idu, R1 idu. So let us think now. E content ige memory location, e content memory alli nodidre, e memory address ige, e address ige, for this address this is the content. When you see from the memory point of view, if you take this address, this as address, then that address contains this this content. Now here instruction is given something like this. This is pop instruction. I have to load something from memory. First I have to calculate. So how we calculated in 8086 physical address, like that also here you have to calculate. First it, what in free index it will do, it will first calculate the address. How it will calculate the address? It will take R1 and it will add offset. R1 is this one, add offset, this becomes this. Now what is the content of this one? That content is moved to R0 and R1 base register, this is base register, R1 is updated 9004. Address is updated. In free index, it will do same thing, but it will not update the base register. In forced index, it will not first update the base, it will not calculate the address using offset. It will just take base register and see the content of that base register. It will move that to R0, then it will update the R1. These are the three use of single this one. In that also different modes are there. From the exam point of view, if you remember the first column, well and good. Free index with the immediate offset, free index with the register offset, free index with the scale register offset. That is the one thing. Free index with the write, free index write back with immediate register and scaled. Then forced index, immediate register, scaled. Three things if you remember from the exam point of view. Very good. And this one. So now we have LDR instructions. So that one instruction is sufficient, whatever I explained. If you want, you can go through this one for further explanation. So following this table shows the store instruction. Store instruction also we have write back, free index and forced index. It also works in the same way. So better whatever I explain here, that much you try to remember, because this chapter contains most of the instructions and student will feel complicated when they see these instructions. So just try to analyze whatever explained. Next, multiple register transfer. So once again, the video's the time is exceeded more than 25 minutes. I will stop here, and next video we will continue multiple register transfer.